Hello everyone, hope all of you guys are doing pretty well, right? Okay, so today one of my friend asked me how to extend the connector in order to support custom attributes which are not at all defined in the target system, as well as these attributes are not available inside OIM. So it really sounds very good to me, so I have decided to make a video on this in order to help every one of you. Okay, so as I already discussed about LDAP connectors in my previous session, so I am continuing after that. So if you didn't watch my previous video, then I must recommend you to go and watch my earlier videos and then come back here. Okay, so let's start. In order to add a custom attribute, what are the changes we need to perform? Any ideas, you guys? What are the changes we need to perform? Yes, the first change which we need to perform is to add a custom attribute to the process form, right? The second change which we need to apply is we need to create a custom attribute and custom object class in the LDAP server, right? The third changes which I have to perform is to inform the connector about this attribute. The fourth changes which I need to perform here is to map the OIM defined attribute with the LDAP defined attribute. We need to map the attributes, right? And at the end, we will conclude by testing our entire setup. Okay, so let's continue. So first, what we need to do, we need to create or we need to add a custom attribute to the process form. So how we are going to do that? Let's continue. First, I am going to the sysadmin console. Let me open the sysadmin console. Okay, this is my sysadmin console. In order to perform any UI changes, I already discussed in my earlier video that you need to create a sandbox, right? So let me create a sandbox. Let me give a name. I want to give the name as project hours. I want to add this attribute in LDAP as well as in OIM, and I want to create a sync up. Okay, click on save and close. So my sandbox is ready to use. Now I have to add the custom attribute in the process form of the application instance, right? Click on the form designer, which is inside provisioning configuration. Now here, since I have already an existing application instance, and with that particular application instance, I have already an associated form. So I just want to add a new attribute in the form itself. Let's select the resource type. For me, it's the LDAP server, so it's a LDAP user here. Okay. Now click on search. This is my the form name. This is the process form name. Click here. It has been opened. Now click on this particular button, which is going to create a custom field for you. So click here. Now I want to add a text field. So select the first option. Click on OK. Now here the display level name. You need to give the display level name. For me, I am going to give the name as project hours. The same thing I am going to give here as project hours. Now in the description, I want to give how much time an employee works in a project. Click on the constant searchable. Now click on save and close. Once you click on save and close, you will be able to see that, you see, the project hours has been created over here, right? Okay, now the first part is done from our end. Now we need to create a custom object class as well as custom attribute in the LDAP server. So let's go to the LDAP server. So this is my LDAP server. I need to create a object class and object class and custom attribute here, right? So what I am going to do, I am first going to create a custom attribute. So I have already created a LDAP file here. If you see the LDAP file format here, what you need to give, you need to define the schema. What you are doing here, you are adding a new attribute type. The syntax of this attribute type is directory string. Okay. Now here I'm going to give the OID number as 591, whatever you want to give, but be sure that this particular object identifier is not being used in your environment. Okay. Now the name here I want to give as project hours. Copy it. Now this part is done. My attribute has been created. Now I need to modify, or I need to modify the server with this attribute, right? I want to add this particular attribute to the LDAP server. So in order to add any attribute using command line, you need to use LDAP modify command. Okay. So I'm going to use a LDAP modify command over here. Let me open my server. So I'm in the bin folder of my LDAP server. So I need to perform the LDAP modify, right? So for LDAP modify command, what you need to give, I'm going to run this command. As you can see here, let me just show you. This is my LDAP file, which is new attribute.ldf, where I have just written all my content. This is the password file where my password of the directory manager has been stored, and my local host machine is where the LDAP server is located. So let me modify it. As you can see, the server has been modified. Now let me just search whether I am able to search this attribute or not. As you can see, this is the attribute which we have just now added. How much time my employer works, and this reference or the syntax which I am going to use, or the data which I am going to save in my this particular attribute, is a directory string. Means it's a string type. And in OIM we have created a text field. So both are in matching case. Okay. Now once this part is done, we need to define an object class which is going to hold my attribute, right? So let me create the object class. So I've also written a LDAP file for the object class. Let me name the LDAP file project, how much effort our employee is putting. Now it contains the attribute, the name which we have given there as project hours, right? As you can see, the name was project hours. Let me copy the name. Let me paste over here, project hours. So here this particular object class has been inherited from inet.org person, and it may have this particular attribute. So it is not a mandatory attribute for this particular object class. Instead of that, it's an optional attribute which I am going to define. Let me save. Again, let me modify the server. Using the same command. As you can see, the server modification has been done. Now, once the LDAP server is ready to use, what I need to do? We need to map or we need to inform the connector about the server, right? So how we are going to inform the connector? So for that, open the design console. Let me open the design console. Now here, go to the development tools, go to the administration, click on the lookup definition, search for the lookup LDAP dot configuration. So if you come down here, you will be able to see that what are the object classes which you want to manage via OIM. So there is a field called account object classes. So you need to add your field over here. You need to add your field over here, that is project, right? We have added a new attribute, or we have added a new object class. The name of the object class was, just a moment, let me just cross verify the name of the object class. So the name of the object class was project. So what I am going to map here, I am going to add that particular object class in account object classes. Along with that, you need to add this particular object class in the object classes to synchronize. Okay? So once you're done with this part, what we need to do? There is one more lookup which we need to update. The lookup name is lookup dot LDAP dot OUD. Since we are using OUD, so we need to go to OUD configuration. In the OUD configuration, what we need to do, we need to give the account object classes and the object classes synchronize here, object classes to synchronize. Here we need to add project, the new object class, because we are using OUD, right? So for OUD lookup, you also need to modify. If it's different for your environment, so you need to modify as per your environment. Okay, so I am done with the OUD part. That object class has been created, the custom attribute has been created. In the custom object classes, we have already added the custom attribute. Now we have informed our LDAP server or our OIM server that these two object classes exist in the environment and we need to synchronize the object class, right? Now once this part is done, we need to perform a mapping, right? That OIM project hours is going to map with OUD project hours, right? We need to map this thing. In order to perform the mapping, again click on the lookup definition. Here you will be able to see something called LDAP.UM. Let me just search it. It's LDAP.UM.provisioning attribute. Means what are the attributes we want to provision from OIM to the target system. So here we need to add the new attribute. So what was the code key? The code key means what is the name of the attribute or the field which is defined in OIM, and decode key means that corresponding to that particular OIM field, what is the attribute name that is defined in the target server, that is the LDAP server. So for me it's project hours, right? Here also I have defined the new attribute as project hours. But here there is no space at all. Okay, so go and save this lookup also. So once you are done with this part, what we need to do? We need to map few of the things that, let's say, there should be some task which is going to update all your details related to that particular attribute to the target server, right? So for that, what we need to do? You need to go to process definition. Double click on the process definition. Search for the object name. For me, the object name is LDAP user. Now here you need to add a new task which is going to modify or which is going to add or update your working hour or your project hours in the target system. So click on add. The task name which I am going to give as project hours updated. So the main task or main significance of this creating a new task or process task is to update your target system with the OIM field, OIM data. Okay, required for completion. No, I don't want it to be mandatory field. Allow cancellation while pending and allow multiple instances. Go and click on save. Now once this part is done, click on the integration. Click on add. Here click on adapter and you will be able to see adapter LDAP update. So this is a Java task which is written over here, which comes along with the connector bundle itself. So inside, this is a Java file which is, when you want to perform any operation, this is the code which is behind your operation to be performed in the server. Okay, click on save. So once the adapter has been created, what you need to do? You need to map all these things. So first go into process instance key, map to process data and click on save. Sorry. Now in the object type, click here, search for literal, and here you need to give the object type as user, right? Because this is our object class which is defined in the server. Now in the IT resource field, for us the IT resource field or the mapping should be, it's a IT resource name, right? And that IT resource name has been defined in a particular lookup. The lookup name looks like this. For me it's UD LDAP USR underscore server. So let me just save this thing. I need to map this thing further. I just want to cross verify the data. Just a moment. So this is the name which we need to give for LDAP server. That is UD underscore LDAP underscore USR underscore server. Okay. Now once this part is done, we need to perform the entire mapping. So I am still left with few of the mapping. Again, go and double click on project tower updated. Now click on the integration. Click on the IT resource. Now here I am going to map it with a literal. And the value is UD underscore LDAP underscore USR underscore server. So this is the IT resource which is defined for that particular user. Okay. Now click on close. Now in the field label, what field you want to populate? It's again a literal. The name of the field is project hours. Click on save. Now adapter return is the response code. Click on save. Now once you're done with the mapping, this mapping is nothing but, since this is a Java code, ADP underscore LDAP update, this is a Java code, and by giving these values you are doing nothing but you are giving some arguments to that Java file so that it will get correct argument, and based on your argument is going to perform the action or perform the task. Once this part is over, you need to click on the response, click on add. What are the response this particular task is going to generate? Obviously one is unknown and the second is success. When this is succeeded, project hours updated. Now the task status should be C, which is corresponding that the task has been completed. Now click on save. Now once this task has been created, we are done from our end. Okay. Click on save. Now let me just create a new user and let me just try to update the user via OIM. Okay, let's see. So before that we did one mistake over here. The mistake is that we need to regenerate the view. Okay, once you regenerate this view, we need to publish the sandbox. Click on publish sandbox. Yes, I want to publish the sandbox. So the sandbox has been published. So these changes have been made available to all the users. So let me check once again that in the form designer, that particular form or that particular attribute has been present there or not. LDAP USR table. As you can see, this particular value is there. Okay. Now we are going to perform the test. I'm going into the HR system. Let me create a new employee here. Let me give the name as Amit Kumar Gupta. Employee type employee. Organization is information system. Location is Los Angeles. Yes, active. Let me go into the job description. No, he is not a manager. Okay. It's head of department. Now click on create employee. So as you can see, the employee has been created. Now let me reconcile that employee to the OIM server. So in order to reconcile, let me run the GTC which is defined for me here. Click on run now. Let me just search this user. As you can see, the A Gupta has been created in OIM. Now I am going to provision this user to Enterprise Directory Server. Let me check whether this new attribute is propagating to the target system or not. Validating the custom attribute setup. Okay. Click here. Name is A. Gupta. I have given the password. The container DN for me is OUD people. The project hour I am going to set as 15. Okay, that's it from mine. Click on update. Now click on submit. Let me refresh. As you can see, the enterprise OUD has been provisioned. Okay. So there is an issue. As you can see, there are two different accounts has been created over here, right? So let me just simply modify this account. The second account came here because the scheduler is also running, which is evaluate user policy. Let me select 15, click on update, click on submit. Okay, let me refresh. The project hour has been updated. The task should trigger from here, right? As you can see, the project hour updated task has been triggered, which we have created for sending the attribute from OIM to the target system. Okay, let me just search this particular attribute in the server on whether it's propagated to the server or not. For this, let me open the Apache Directory Studio. Okay, let me connect to the, let me select. Let me select the user ID is A. Gupta's subtree search. Subtree search. Okay, the A. Gupta is there. As you can see, the project hours has been updated to 15. Okay, so in this way we can extend our connector in order to support some additional attribute, and I hope that you are now clear that how you are going to extend all these things. But yes, there is one more thing which you need to take care over here, that in an employer, in an organization, there are lots of existing users, right? So how you are going to update the attribute for this particular user or for all the users which are already existing in the server? For that I am definitely going to create a new video, but for now I am done, and I hope you people will like the video, and thanks for watching it.